Hi YouTube, it's Mama Dodon. Little Fun Charlotte is over playing in the corner, but she may show up in this video at some point. And today is my first Sell It Saturday video, where I get on and I talk to you guys basically about what I did throughout the entire week to earn money. I have so many updates for you guys, so this video might be a little long, but there were so many things that happened in terms of small business and just income in general in this last week for me. Let's just dive right in. Right now, as I told you guys last Saturday, I think is when I published the video, I am not investing money in any business ventures right now because I just don't have the money to invest. So all of the investments that I'm making right now are time investments. And here is how I turned my time into money over the last 7 days. I think it was 7 days, maybe 5 days. So something that I've done in the past is I've gone out, I've researched the plants in my area and I found ones that are producing seeds and I've harvested those seeds to resell. So knowing that that was a way that I made money in the past, I decided why not go ahead and try right now. I didn't realize how many plants actually had seeds available in the spring. I always thought that plants had seeds available in the fall, but I started researching, I started looking, I kept my eye out. And I found a lot of things that I was able to harvest and potentially sell. Nothing has sold yet, but I spent 2 days this week going out and harvesting tree seeds. I harvested maple seeds and I harvested juniper seeds. So first of all, I wanted to make sure that these seeds would actually grow. I didn't want to sell people seeds that wouldn't grow. So I have been spending the last week working on starting the seeds, getting them to root. My maple seeds, for the most part, have rooted. So I went out, I gathered a bunch of maple seeds, and just 2 days ago, I listed those maple seeds on eBay, Etsy, any place online where I could find where I would be able to ship the maple seeds from my home out to the customer. I'm also going to take all the maple seeds that I've had sprouted, which is about 100, and I'm going to plant them in little rows in my parents' yard. I don't want them to grow too big. It's not gonna be like this big nursery setup, but basically, the maple that I got grows relatively fast. So it should grow about a foot high by late June, mid-July. And at that point, I'm gonna reharvest the trees from the ground and hopefully sell them as actual rooted trees. Right off the bat, just with those maple seeds, there's two different kinds of income that I potentially made for myself. One, I'm trying to sell just the seeds with directions for how to plant them. And two, I'm growing the seeds into trees that within a month or a month and a half, I'll be able to sell as well. Juniper seeds are a little harder because they take longer to sprout. So right now I am just attempting to grow them. The great thing about juniper is that it is traditionally grown as a bonsai tree, which means that once those seeds start, I can either sell the seeds as like seeds for juniper, or I can sell the sprouted seeds as beginning bonsai trees, which increases their value. So here in probably 2 months, 3 months, I will be able to make money from those sprouted juniper seeds if I can get them to sprout. In terms of online services that I'm attempting to sell, I actually began selling runes readings. Runes here with me, so I can kind of like show you guys what they are. But it's like a fortune teller type reading, and I've been reading runes since I was 18 years old. It's something I've always been really interested in, but they're these little, they can be on stones or wood. They're just these little symbols. I believe they're from Nordic folklore, but don't quote me on that. But either way, I read runes as like a fortune telling thing. And basically what I did online was I just offered free readings and people could give donations. And that actually worked out really well. I was getting about every three readings I was doing, I was earning about $5, and it takes me about 5 minutes to do a reading, which means by doing those readings, even though some of them were free and some of them were donation based, I was making around $20 an hour when I did the readings. So that's another little way that I've been making money. And that was a really easy thing for me to do once Charlotte went to bed at night or when I was just having a slow day and I could sit down on the computer. That was one thing that I really targeted. Obviously with the seeds, I have to just kind of wait for them to sprout. And once you plant them, there's really not much more you can do. You just have to wait. Doing the runes readings, although I was just doing it donation based, so I didn't even know how much money I was gonna make, it allowed me to feel like I was actually in control of my financial situation and I was doing something and I was actually working consistent hours at bringing in money. The runes reading was really the only like side gig type thing that I made money off of this week. But one big thing that I've learned in the small business world is that income is a long game. You have to invest your time and oftentimes your money and then wait for those returns. So that's what I'm doing with the tree seeds right now. The runes was a really fast return on investment of time, which was awesome. And I hope to continue doing that. But the seeds, I think, for the amount of money that I'll make per hour are going to pay me way more. Once they're sprouted and hopefully selling, they'll probably bring in around $50 an hour, whereas the runes are just bringing in $20 an hour. Another thing that I had talked with you guys about was YouTube. As you guys know, I am not yet monetized, but I do have some news on that, so hold on just one second. But I just wanted to talk about my YouTube channel in general and a few little things that I'm doing. One, I'm working on promoting, I'm posting some videos on Reddit, I've joined a few Facebook groups that I think will kind of help me get involved in mom communities and financial communities that are on YouTube. And then another thing I'm doing is I'm trying to create content that stays within like my idea of being a single mom channel, but is also appealing to a wider crowd. So I posted my divorce video and a few other videos that kind of weren't normal for me, like the morning routine video, but still fit in with the niche that I'm trying to create on this channel while staying true to myself and also reaching out to a wider audience to hopefully bring in more people to my channel, which of course will get me monetized. But I'm just trying to be completely transparent with you guys. You know that I'm a financial channel. You know that I am trying to earn money, and one of the ways I'm doing that is YouTube. Which brings me to my last point with the YouTube channel. I don't know what you guys did over this last week. What's wrong, Charlotte Lou? But whatever you did, it's working. So as you guys know, you need 4,000 watch hours to be monetized on YouTube, and then also 1,000 subscribers. I am almost to 1,000 subscribers, but I told you guys I wasn't really anywhere near my 4,000 watch hours. Well, this last week I jumped from 2,200 watch hours to 3,000 watch hours. That's like an insane increase. So whatever you guys did, however many videos of mine you watched or had just playing in the background, thank you. You guys are amazing. And I may just be monetized way faster than I anticipated. So with my Amazon business, Amazon has now, it seems, opened up all of my products. And I just noticed this yesterday. That's awesome. That means I can now get my business back to 100% capacity. But when I started reaching out to wholesalers that I buy supplies from in order to create my products, a lot of them are either out of stock or not in business at all right now due to quarantine things. I order things from all over the world. A lot of them are based in the US. More than 50% of my suppliers are based in the US. They're struggling to get things in stock right now because they ran out of stock during quarantine. A lot of them are back up and running now, but they don't have the things I need in stock. The ones from overseas can't even ship to the US right now. So although Amazon's allowing me to ship in products, I still don't have the supplies needed to manufacture products to ship in. I have a bunch of things in my office that I will be sending in, but that's not nearly as much as I need for my business to be stable and running full force. Although Amazon has opened up, which is great and super good news, I'm still in the waiting game right now as I wait for my suppliers to get their businesses back on track so then I can get my business back on track. So that leads me to next week's goals. What am I going to be doing next week to attempt to make money? I'm going to be moving as much inventory as I possibly can into Amazon. I did get in some orders for parts that I'll need to manufacture certain products. So I'll be working on manufacturing those products, getting them packaged, sending them into the warehouse so I can begin to get my Amazon business really running again. I'm also going to be continuing to do my runes readings because it turned out to be actually a very viable income source. And the fact that it was donation-based made me feel really good because people could pay what they thought my service was worth. So I didn't really have any guilt associated with like running that type of business. It made me feel good about myself and it brought in income at the same time. Obviously, I'll continue to watch my little seeds, make sure that they're growing, transplant them if needed, do anything I need to do tree seed-wise. I also want to get out there and find other things in nature that I can sell. And a big thing that I want to focus on is honeysuckle. And I intend to go out and gather honeysuckle as much as possible. Right now, I want to get a bunch of honeysuckle flowers. Honeysuckle is actually an insanely invasive species here in the Midwest US, so eliminating it is a good thing, and getting rid of as much of it as possible is a good thing. So my plan is to go out, gather a bunch of honeysuckle flowers, find some ways to turn those into money. Dry them, make syrups, make jellies, I don't know. I have a bunch of ideas floating around in my head. I just kind of have to see what can work and what I can legally do in my home, because I know in some states you can sell like homemade food items and in other states you can't. So I have to look up all the laws for that, figure out what I'm able to do in the area that I am, and then take the flowers and make what I can with them. A big thing that I think will be a good thing for me to do is to dry them, turn them into a powder that people can use in aromatherapy type things, soaps, stuff like that. So that will be a big thing for me with the flowers that I will attempt to make money with honeysuckle. Another thing I can do with honeysuckle is I can gather the branches and make a bunch of crafts with them, which I will be doing. I'm not sure if I'll get to that this week. It's a big thing I want to focus on is just the flowers, and then restocking my Amazon business is obviously huge. So I'm going to be working on that as much as possible, doing the runes at times when Charlotte will allow me to sit on my computer, and getting outside with her and harvesting honeysuckle while we're at it, which I'll try to make a video for you guys so you can kind of see how to harvest honeysuckle. If you guys wanted, yes, I see an eyeball. Kind of looks like an eyeball. It's a rune. Can you say rune? So if you guys want to get outside and harvest honeysuckle yourself, you can kind of see the process of harvesting it, what you're looking for. Most places in the U.S. have it, and it is an invasive species, so if you want to get out there, chop it down, make your own money from it, you'll be able to see how to harvest that in a video coming up this week. So yeah, this week was decent. I at least brought in income. I feel in control of my financial situation right now. I'm going to continue to work as hard as possible over the next week. I will see you guys next Saturday for another Sell It Saturday video where I overview every single way that I made money throughout the entire week prior. Charlotte's getting a little burst of energy up and she's gonna jump off of these chairs, which we're sitting quite up high on. So I'm going to let you guys go. As always, thank you so much for watching, and if you'd like to see my next Sell It Saturday video where I talk about all the ways that I have made income as a single mom, feel free to come back next Saturday for that video. As always, thank you so much for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next one.